Hi guys, and welcome back to SciTench. In today's video, we're gonna have a look at the capping beam rebar drawing. We're gonna check all the information provided by two designers, and we're gonna have a look at the mysterious abbreviations. We're gonna go through the bar bending schedule, and also I'm gonna show you one of the sections provided for the capping beam. So yeah guys, let's go. So guys, this is the capping beam rebar drawing for the block A. As you can see, this is actually the sheet one of three. That means there are going to be three drawings, but on this one, on the first one, we got all the plan, the key plan, which we're going to have to use using another drawing. Obviously, we're going to make sure if this is for construction. We're going to go through the notes in a minute. You can see here we got CB1, CB2, CB4, all here nice marked. So as I said, yeah, we're gonna go through the legend, and in this case the notes are very good really, because as you can see here, everything is described in here. So even if you don't know what this mysterious abbreviation means, everything is explained in this table, guys. So it's very nice, I really like it. You can open the drawing and you know actually what's there. As I said, when I was covering the GA drawing, I said it's always very worth to look at the legend and look at the notes, as you can find all this information. Not always, obviously, not always, but in most cases, if you go here, you're gonna think, what is 3EF? 3EF, if you don't know it, if you use it for the first time, the answer is here. But anyway, we got cover to reinforcement to be beams, top and size 50 millimeters and bottom 75 millimeters. So that was our piles projection as well. So it has to be 75 millimeters for the bottom of the steel. Slab top and bottom 50 millimeters unless noted otherwise, and all sides to be 50 millimeters. So it's very good information. We got a concrete here as well, all concrete grade C35-45. So if we talk about the concrete, if you talk about the cover, that's the drawing when we're looking for information. This is the drawing. Obviously we compare it with a GA general arrangement drawing, but that's when we're looking for information, and this of course has to be confirmed with the client and double checked and triple checked. But this is the drawing about the steel, about the reinforced concrete. So you can see here notes on reinforcement. For general arrangement information, see the latest drawing. We had a look before at it. So as I said here, we got the marks here. So you can see this is beam CB3, let's say. So CB3 is this one from here to here. And we might have a look at the CB3. So CB3 is that beam here, and we got all information on the CB3 provided here. So once again, we got the width of the beam and the depth of the beam, and we got all information about the rebar coming in the beam here. So I'm gonna go again through this information. We're gonna have a look at the block C as well, but what's important on this drawing? Yeah, we got the layout with all beams shown. So all the rest beams apart from CB1 and CB3 and CB2, we're gonna be looking for the sheet 2 and 3 obviously. But what we can see on this drawing, we got nice sections here. And that's what I'm saying. Once we start in to construct particular elements, we want to know all information, including the rebar drawing. Even if we're not going to be dealing much with the rebar, we want to see rebar drawing, because this is a really nice section showing how the slab meeting the capping beam. And as you can see here, it's meeting the capping beam in two different ways, I would say. Well, the top of the capping beam is flush with the top of the slab, but in this case, the levels are not the same. So that's what I said when I was talking about the GE drawing. And in this case, we got also the upstand, but upstand probably going to be constructed later with the slab, so that's not important. But you can see there's two differences, one slab going at this level and one slab coming at this level. And this level need to be marked by us. What else we got on this drawing? This is actually quite a lot of information on this drawing, as we got the columns as well. So you can see here we got the column starters. So column C1 in this case, it shows 16 number 25 mil bars, quite a lot of bars here. And you can see here, that's what we have here, C1, we got C11 as well, probably going to be on other drawing. And we got the sections, which is number 5 in this case, section number 5 through the column. So we know how the column going to be looking. And if we go back to GA drawing, this is our 300 by 1 meter column. So that's why all the information needs to be combined. So all the drawings have to be kept together, so you can have a look at them. With this drawing, there is always a drawing called bar bending schedule. And that's the one. Is if you can have a look here, it says BS, which stands for bending schedule, and this is DR, which is drawing. That's how you can actually find the information when you got only the numbers. So BS spending schedule and DR stands for drawing. As you can see here, we got beam one here, and that's the rebar coming to the beam. So all this rebar here from number one all the way down 40, so that's actually a CB2. So all these bars have to come to our CB1, and all this information here, you got the type and the size of the bar, you got the number of the members, which is a number of the elements of the beams. So CB1, it's only one beam. So the total number of the bar number one in this beam is 194, the length of the bar total and the shape codes. The shape codes, all this stuff, guys, I'm going to cover in another video, as we're going to go at the general information here today regarding the layouts and the sections for the rebar drawings for blocks A and C. So, guys, let me show you the rebar drawing for block C, which is provided by the different designer in this case. And we're going to go again here, quick as strip removed. So that's, we assume this is the latest revision, of course, you're going to make sure. And what we have here, we got reinforcement notes. So cover as well, 75 mil, so same story with the columns. I can see here it's 30 mil, so it's a little bit less than on the other one. Reinforcement is listed as bending, and minimum reinforcement lapse. So this is very important information as well. But as you can see here on this notes and on this legend, you don't know this abbreviation. So the other designer was actually better in this to explain what it means. Obviously, once you're gonna do one or two jobs, you remember this, you got it in your head and you're sure what you're doing. But this is always good to just copy, paste it in, and all the guys knows what it stands for. So as you can see here, we got CB1. So same story here. We got markup here for the beam, CB1. And the beam is here. We got the levels here as well, top of concrete. We got the grid lines marked, so that's all we need. You know, the orientation of the beam here now. And we got bars to be displaced around 200 hole if required, once final sizes. So all this information, it's good. We got the sections as well. I'm just going to go quickly to the bar bending schedule for this one. So you got the bar bending schedule. It's exactly the same story as with the other one. You got a cubby beam, CB1, all marks here. How many members, all the stuff. So this is all the same. Guys, my new website going to be complete in 2-3 weeks. And then you're going to be able to download these things as I'm going to put some information like this. I'm going to put the drawings there as well with the explanation so you can download and have a look yourself. So I'm going to go again here. As you can see on this drawing, we don't have information about the columns. So that's another one. We're going to be looking for the information on the other, on some other drawing. So that's what we have in here. We know there are going to be columns, but we don't have any information, as this is only the capping beam RC details. That's what it says. So I got this drawing here, and as you can see here, it shows all the capping beam here. And it's giving us the information about the columns as well. So C1, C1. Obviously, guys, you probably noticed this, that this is a column C1, but this is C1 for block C. So this is different drawing, different designers, different block. The C1, it means it might be completely different, and it will be completely different to block A. But you got all sections here. So you got a C1 here. It's 825 mil bars, the bar mark number 11, and we got a section 3 here, so we're gonna have a look how these columns is looking. So section 3 is here, so that's how it looks. Yeah, we got 8 bars, and that we know gonna be 25 mil bars. But just to not miss it, this is C1 for block C, so this is different to block A, and this is provided on other drawings. So once you're gonna be doing call-ups by any chance, you need to remember that you need to call this stuff in as well, apart from the capping beam. So this is a little bit different to the block A. So guys, I'm gonna go back in here and we have a look at some sections here. So section number 2 here, as you can see, that's the section through the beam in this point. So I'm gonna show you quickly what that means here on the section drawing. I'm gonna go quickly here. And I'm going to explain you, so you're going to know what that means really. So we got 8H16 number 48T, and we got 8H16 48B. So we got bar mark 48, guys. If you want to check how the bar mark 48 looks, so you got it here actually. That's the bar mark 48, that's the one. You see that dot shows the bar, and you can always refer to bar bending schedule. And you got 48 here. So you got all information here about bar mark 48. You can see here it's confirmed 16 mil. And this always you have to check as well, because sometimes you got the discrepancy between the drawing showing the capping beam and the bar bending schedule. And this is quite important. But the information about the bar mark 48 is here. So I'll go back quickly here to that section. And just to quickly show you what that means really is. So the first number here is the number of bars. As I put it here, number of bars in the section, H16, that means the for us the information is here, it's a bar diameter. So I got here 48. This is actually the bar marks. That's the bar mark, that's the bar number. So bar mark, so that's the bar number from schedule. So the T guys, T stands for top. So that our bar is gonna be here, top. 8 number here, that means top, and 8 number at the bottom. So that's how the section gonna be looking. And if you look at before the abbreviation, each face, that means each face, so that's your external face and that's your internal face. So that's the both faces gonna have a rebar as well, rebar number 33. So the section is quite okay. So you can see now the number of bars, bar diameter, bar mark, it's a bar mark from the bar bending schedule, and you got the information here what layer the bar gonna be situated. So guys, I think that will be all in today's video. I just showed you how the capping beam gonna be looking. You see some sections, you see the column drawings, and you saw the schedules as well. And guys, if you got any questions, please leave the comments and I try to explain as best as I can. And also guys, as I said, in 2-3 weeks time I'm gonna make it available for you to download some of the drawings, so you're gonna have a look yourself. So thank you again for watching guys. If you like it, just don't forget to leave the thumbs up. Just make sure you're gonna subscribe to my channel if you wanted more information like this, if you want to see more videos, and turn the notifications on. So yeah guys, see you next time.